Noble, I will go.
I highly recommend the brand Chessex. They all come in like these little words. What is this? It's not glass. It's like a clear plastic box. They stack together nicely.
I found a cute, nice set. It's so cute.
Oh, that one's cute.
I like the things inside. That's my favorite.
Oh, I love those, and I need them. I want to make a necromancer character.
Same.
So, typically, I'm not the biggest fan of dice where they have something inside, because sometimes those things are upside down, and that makes me unhappy. Also, how is the stream delay now? Is it better?
Your broadcast is still ended? Oh wait, that might be me. Never mind.
Yeah.
Hold on.
It's still buffering, but... Hold on.
I'm gonna go shout at my brother. He knows I stream. He knows I stream at this time.
If it helps, we're on a map at the moment.
Feel their kidneys.
Oh, don't tempt me.
Damn. Chessex on the Barnes & Noble website sells Pound O Dice. It is literally just called the Pound O Dice.
Not too bad. It's like maybe like a few seconds. 30 seconds or so.
I can live with a few seconds. Oh. You know, I just realized I don't have a chat thing.
Nope.
Watching the stream, Nishu just said it was like delayed still, like, or no, it would still look ended. Because for me, I keep getting the little delays, like the buffering things.
Good little question. Just typed in chat.
I don't think your chat's delayed, I think it's just stream in general.
Yeah, no, I put a chat box on stream so we can actually physically count the delay.
We just start counting. 1, 2, 3.
Oh, hey, Zai.
Hey.
How
I wish things would work. Why must you break?
I mean, all things considered, even if there is like a huge delay, it'll look normal on the VOD.
This is true, except for all the time we spend talking about the delay.
Oh yeah, they'll be like, what the hell? Like, people watching will be like, what are they talking about?
What delay?
I guess they had some issues with the stream. Luckily, I'm just watching the VOD. Alright, so.
Okay, last one, I promise.
Alright, so you guys are heading, through. So, you said you guys wanted to head north.
Yes, we were eventually going to end up at that border town in between Kingdom of Errol, the clans of the Allhammer and Tentel.
Okay, so
that's in between the Sky Daggers.
That's actually its own city state. It is independent from every kingdom.
Neat.
There are two of those. There's that one, and then one a bit further north. But yeah, so you guys can head along that north road. Provisions.
vigilance. Alright, what do we got?
Oh yeah, I remember. I was gonna go up to the bar and order some stuff for us.
Okay.
I'm kind of just standing there at like still in the spot, and I kind of just like look over. I'm like, what are we doing? What are we doing, guys? Because I definitely didn't space out through that whole conversation.
We're living.
Okay. Cool.
We live. Okay. Yeah. So okay, I go up to the bar and I call over the bartender.
Yeah. So it's more of a counter. Like a
counter,
reception,
bar.
like a reception desk. But
wait,
yeah,
where are we? I thought we were in the
you're in the Hunter's
Lodge. The Hunter's Lodge.
Yeah, it's not a bar. The Hunter's Lodge isn't a bar. It says
what the hell was I?
It says drinks.
I'm gonna say the first.
Food.
Okay, I was gonna say I thought the first time I was there, I ordered and I ate at like the counter.
Yeah, no. So it says drink and food, but it's mostly for hunters to go. Record their kills and their hunts, pick up contracts, that kind of thing.
Okay. I didn't really ask too much the first time. Okay.
But yeah,
you
can
buy provisions. You can't.
No, you can.
Oh, you can? Okay. I call over the person.
Yep, she walks over and is like, hello, can I help you? You and your friends have been staring at that, demon an awful lot.
Yeah, he's a pretty, crazy-looking, person. Anywho,
5 minutes.
We would like to get some provisions. We're about to make our way out of town.
Yeah, of course. What type of hunt are you going on?
A hunt for information.
Right, so long haul hunt.
Yeah, that one.
Just suddenly the mouse is on the counter, just like yes, like that.
Just like, oh god, this guy has no charisma. Just, help him.
But my apologies, I you startled me. I didn't hear you come onto the counter. Yes, of course. How many long haul packs are you going to need?
Six. We're gonna need six.
Six?
Do we need six? Because, wait, I
actually, change it. Five.
I was gonna say, like, me and you could share.
Yeah.
We're just small.
Yeah.
Five. Okay. She kind of walks over, off, and comes back a few times. It takes her about three trips. She brings over these, sacks. Well, these are large sacks. They're bigger than Asta.
Oh, damn. Well, everything's bigger than you, but...
most things are bigger than you. And she puts them on the counter. It's like, okay, so these have provisions for 30 days, such as food. They've got some torches in them. They have some basic herbs and stuff for you to help, cook whatever you, catch and kill. They've got some tinder, some fire starters, basically the basics you need for a long haul hunt. Each of these will run you about 2 gold each. So with 5 of them, that'll be 10 gold.
My bad. 10 gold,
which is...
And you can, register whatever you have successfully hunted and killed with any hunter's guild in the world. Well, on the continent, basically.
Cool. I ask everybody for, what was it, 2 gold each?
2 gold each, yeah.
Everybody, we gotta pay for our packs.
Okay. Okie dokie.
Here's my gold.
Okay. Yep. Well, if you're only getting 5, Aster and Flick both only need to pay 1.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I was gonna say they can figure out how to divide them, I suppose.
That wasn't a complicated division. 2 divided by 2. Yeah, as you're all paying up, she's like, and, quick question, you do know about how to, fully register with the Hunter's Guild? And all the benefits that come with?
No.
No?
We get benefits.
Right, well, okay, let me just, explain this for you then. Registering with the Hunter's Guild will give you discounted prices on certain, of our provisions. It'll also, as you bring in and record your various hunts, each will award you a certain amount of points. These are recorded across all hunters' lodges throughout the continent, and as you rack up your points and gain notoriety with such, you will be given a higher bounties and may even be requested specifically for certain tasks. Additionally, the Hunter's Lodge will, provide you with certain, support in certain aspects. As such, we can provide you with lodgings, assist you with certain hunts, provide you with, additional hunters if it is a large hunt that you are undergoing. Such things like that. It's perfectly free to sign up and join the Hunter's Lodge. But we will need you to sign your names.
Like, you guys want to join last
names or just our names?
I
believe just last name. Not everyone has last names.
Yeah, she kind of leans on the counter. Like, I'll be honest with you, sweet. As long as you know what name you signed with, we can then find you. There are some people, they won't admit it, but they've definitely given a fake name. We don't care about that. It's just so that we can record who has what scores.
I signed my name as More Butts.
As what?
What? No, nothing.
What did you say?
I said More Butts.
How dare you?
Spell it out like this.
So, we're joining a guild?
Nice.
You can.
It'll help us with our notoriety.
Yeah, we don't have to. We can.
I'm signing.
Alright. Yeah, she puts out the paperwork in front of you. Wonderful. So, Aster, what name do you sign under?
I sign under Aster.
Alright.
I'm not making up a fake name.
That's fair. So, yeah, it's a basic, sign-in form. It's name, species, or, race, and then, name, species, date. That kind of thing. It is really simple. However, there is one thing at the bottom of it, which is give a passcode.
Passcode.
Yeah. Beep boop beep boop up. Passcode.
As you kind
do
of,
we say a passcode or do we just
you can type
jot
it in
down.
You can type it in your private thing on the Discord.
Okay.
Because as you get to that point, she's like, ah yes, so that passcode there. If we believe that there is a chance, that it may not be you, or for whatever reason, then we will request you to repeat that passcode. That'll be hidden from everyone, and the only way we will know what it is by checking your documentation.
Yeah.
I will also say, the way that the scoring system works with your hunts is, let's say there is you, the six of you hunt a deer, a large deer. That deer weighs a certain amount, and is of a certain breed, with what we would decide is 6 points. That 6 points would then be divided amongst every hunter associated. Okay. And so, instead of all of you getting 6 points, you would each get 1 point.
Ah.
I will sign.
Mm-hmm.
I'll kind of cover up the passcode with my hand while I write it down.
Nobody look at my paper.
Aster picking up an entire the pen that's like the half her body, and just writing with both hands. Don't look. All right. So, Nishu signs up. Aster signs up. Feyre, you sign up. What about you other three?
Yep.
Yeah, I'll sign up.
Yep. Lucia and Rosé?
Yeah, I'll sign.
Okay.
Sure, I guess?
Alright. Yeah, if you sign under any alias, just let me know what that alias is. You don't have to say it verbally. And yeah, just put a passcode thing in the Discord.
In your separate channel. In your separate channel, guys.
Yeah.
For secrecy.
Yeah. Because this may or may not be important later. Tappity tap tap. Right, so. after you all sign up, she's like, wonderful. So, your packs are there. I will file these documents away. And happy hunting.
Thank you. Bye.
Have a lovely day. And yeah, she walks off with the documents that you've all signed.
Now, these bags, are they like sacks or are they actual packs with like armbands? Because like we're already, most of us are already wearing some type of backpack.
Yeah.
I have a bag of holding.
That's yeah. I know. But I was gonna say though, real quick, I don't wanna put anything in the bag of holding in front of anybody else right now because I don't want us to get robbed.
But it's not yours.
I know, but it was just my general like.
So idea. These are large sacks. They take up most of the space in your backpack or your travel pack that you all have. Obviously, Aster's is so a bit big for Aster, but,
Well, that thing's not going in my bag.
No, you've got, like, a little thief's bag you can fit your coins in.
Yeah. That's my purse.
Just pulling out a coin with both hands.
Louis Vuitton.
Alright. So yes, you all have your, travel bags and your packs now. Is there anything else you want to do in the city of Tentailed before you start making your way out of this kingdom?
Let's get out of here.
Let's skedaddle.
Make my way downtown. Walking fast.
Go!
Okay. So you guys, make your way out of the Hunter's Lodge and traverse the city towards the northern entrance. You all saw this on your way in, but we didn't describe your way in. So it is a walled-in city, and the gate is this large arch with two guards stood out either side of the way in, and on both sides of this wall as well. There are two large iron gates, which are both lifted, so you can just walk straight through. But if ever there was a case, you know, these two gates would just slam shut. And you can assume, based on just a quick glance at the mechanism holding them open, that it's more just kind of a, you know, it's a heavy thing to open it, and then just a flick of a switch, or pulling something out of the way, and they just drop down. Basically meaning, if you were under those as they dropped, that's gonna hurt. You're probably gonna be cut in two. But yeah, the guards don't pay you guys any mind. They are stood perfectly still, staring straight forward, unmoving, as though they are statues. The only way you can tell that they're alive is because they're breathing. Yeah, you guys...
Silence.
You guys make your way out of the city. And are now on the road, heading north.
Oh boy.
Road trip.
Are we walking?
Yeah,
we're walking. Yeah.
Well, Lucia, you could fly.
I know. I'd really
fly. Well, I'm not walking. I'm still on Faerith's shoulders, so... I'm relaxed.
Just ass just kicking back, just like, ah, this is nice, isn't it? Just, as you guys are all hiking up a mountain.
It's beautiful out here today.
Meanwhile, we're all tired and...
Esther is just sitting in my hood that I didn't have up, just, you know, using it like a pouch, like this.
Yeah.
Just sat in like a hammock and you...
pulls out like...
Little, tiny coconut.
I'll just fly around from time to time.
All I need is some wings. It'll be perfect.
Until my wings get tired, then I'm gonna walk.
So, you guys are just traversing along the path. I will give a quick warning. Travel is the one thing I am worst at as a DM. Mm. Because I really struggle to make it entertaining.
I mean, it's travel. It's not usually that entertaining.
Mm. Yeah, no. Let me pull up my...
Except that one time in the forest when you actually had a plan.
I didn't have... What plan?
Never mind.
No, what time are you talking about? Hold on.
I'm talking about different things. Never mind. That was very random.
Alright. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, it's about a 10 days walk. Luckily, luckily, walking on the road cuts it in half, so it's only 5 days. If you got a horse, it would cut it in half again.
Yay!
Maybe I should have got
That's
a horse.
What we had last time.
Yeah, well, you don't have a horse this time. you could have, you didn't buy one. Don't blame me for
There's
this.
A horse, ba- there's a horse. Ba-
Let's buy a horse in the next town. I'm gonna buy a horse in the next town.
Okay.
Oh, I like walking. Plus we make less noise, but okay. If that's what everybody else wants too.
I don't care. Because I'm not walking either way.
That's fair. Alright. So. Yeah, you guys make your way for the first day. You make good pace. Luckily, you know, you're traversing by road, so it's not too hard, but eventually the sun begins to set and, you know, it comes to a point where you should probably stop and rest.
Richter.
Obviously you could push on through the night, however that will start to exhaust you in the next day.
Hmm. Y'all breaking or what?
Yeah, should we set up camp? Real quick, in relation to the map, are we before or after the crossroads before the first town?
Let me zoom in. You are before them.
Okay. So let's just, should we just pull to the side, everyone, and make a camp? Do we want to just post up in the middle of the road and be an inconvenience?
Let's just sit on the side.
Yeah, there are are people with carts that might not be too nice in
That's why I said an inconvenience.
Maybe we should go a little ways into, like, the tree area, just so, like,
yeah, are there any trees nearby?
Sort of.
We don't want to get robbed.
Yeah.
For sure.
I'm not getting robbed. I'm getting in this tree.
Make a little burrow within the tree.
Make a little nest.
You won't even be able to tell you're here.
I mean, I'm fine with us, but people knowing that we're nearby, but I mean, obviously, yeah, I don't want to be so close to the road that somebody's like, oh, look, there's five sleeping people. How many of us are there?
Six.
Six sleeping people.
Not
and
five.
And just like, six. Yeah. I had to look at the thing. I was like, wait a minute. Yeah. It's like, oh, look, there's five sleeping people right there. Let's see if I can take anything from them since they're just right there.
So what about one of us keeps guards? And then we switch a few hours.
Yeah, that's the thing. You only need about
technically, six. I don't have to sleep for a while because I can technically do like 2 hours of meditation, I think.
Yeah, you because like, of your elven heritage, you don't have to sleep for as long.
Yeah, so I can I'll take guard duty if you guys want.
You will need to sleep for some of the night, so someone will have to relieve you for part of it.
That's fine. I'll wake them up at like 3 a.m. So who wants to go after me?
Yeah, one of y'all gonna have to. Leader needs to
sleep. I'll do it. That's fine. All right. I'm fine with that. I'll do it.
All right. So, okay. So Faerith, you're taking the first watch?
Yes.
All right. Roll me a perception check.
I forgot I dropped my d20 the other day. I don't feel like going down there and grabbing it. I know exactly where it is. Google. Dice roller.
Also,
you said this was a perception check?
Yeah.
Would this be considered a long sleep or no?
Yes, this is a long rest.
All right.
17. Cool. I got a 12 plus 5.
Yeah.
17. You see nothing.
Okay, I'm good.
You see nothing untoward. It's perfectly normal night. Yeah.
Pretty cool.
It's you kind of just because you stopped a little after sunset. So, just kind of watch the stars and keep an eye on everything. Make sure nothing's going wrong.
I open my pack and I just eat a nice roll.
Yeah, so you've got...
Nom.
In your pack, you have some hard bread. Basically bread tack. You know what that is?
Oh, crap. Yeah, I actually do.
Yeah, it's not the best, but, you know, it doesn't go bad.
I look for cheese in my pack.
There is a bit of cheese, yeah.
I put the cheese on the hard tack.
What else is in the survival pack?
Wait, there's cheese in there?
Yeah.
Astra wakes up from like the fucking dead sleep, like I smell cheese.
Cheese.
Some cheese. Hello? Hmm? Can I have some cheese?
Like the Looney Tunes, she like wakes up half asleep and you see like the trail of scent and she just goes
and floats along the trail of the smell.
Cheese.
Lick, pull out our cheese. I want some cheese. Wake up. Where's our pack? I need cheese.
Damn. But yeah, no, it's a nice night. Quite chill out. It's springtime, so, you know, the weather's not too bad. But I would recommend having a little fire going. Just to, you know, give you guys a little warmth. But beyond that, yeah, it's chilled out time.
Nice.
After a few hours, it's kind of time for you to get your rest. So you kind of give Nishu a quick sort of prod awake.
I just repeatedly poke them in the arm, like, hey, 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 hey.
What do you want?
It's time for you to take your turn at the watch.
Oh, right. I said I would do that. Yeah. I remember that one. All right. I'll get up and kind of stretch a little bit. Still a little sleepy, but I'm awake.
All right. Now, so yeah, Nishu, you begin your watch as Ferris goes to sleep.
Good night. Have a good sleep.
Thank you.
Alright, Nishu, now it's your turn to make a perception check.
Hiya. 9.
Okay.
Not great.
Always fear when the DM laughs. No, you're fine. You don't see anything. You know, you're... I mean, obviously, yeah, it's a very starry night. It's about middle of spring. It's quite nice. Well, I say middle of spring, kind of like early middle of spring. But yeah, it's a very cloudless night, so there's plenty of stars.
I'm gonna look at the stars.
Yeah, they're very distracting. Very pretty though, but very distracting. Yeah, you don't like much like Ferris before you. You don't see much, just the stars and the night sky.
Let's see.
Yeah, the night passes on, and eventually the sun begins to rise again.
Wish I had a little trumpet that I can go.
I mean, I believe Flick has some drums you could steal.
Nah. I'll do it nice. I won't poke everyone, but I'll just be like, hey, it's time to get up.
I shake like
And then I'll poke Faerith.
Morning already.
As revenge. Hey.
I wake up. Hello. I'm not even upset. I'm just like, hello.
All right.
Revenge for poking.
So.
You guys don't want to get up yet.
That's
we gotta go back on the road.
Gotta go.
You guys gotta go back on the road. I'm gonna go sit on a new person's shoulder.
Who will the mouse choose today?
Rose, I'm sitting with you.
Okie dokie.
All right, so
I hope you're nice and comfy.
Day 2 of traveling. Yeah. The morning. I assume you all have a bit of breakfast before you set off.
Yeah.
My cheese. My morning cheese.
Is there any meat in this pack? Like,
I put my hand up, effectively.
Is there like salt pork and like?
Yeah, there's some dried meats. Nice. It's a bit chewy, you know, but...
I slice up the meat real thin, like, and I put some of it in a pan, and then I put the cheese to...
Where did you get a pan?
Oh, yeah, do I have a... I thought there was cooking supplies in one of our packs.
Might be.
No, I thought there was only food in there.
Yeah, I think there was food in there.
No, I know, but doesn't our normal pack have, like... Do I not have a pan? We need to buy a pan. I roast a little bit.
What do you
want to
buy? A medium saucepan.
Damn. Never mind. I just eat my fucking cold fucking meat.
little bread. Ready for the day.
Esther.
Yeah.
I have a deal for you.
Okay, what's the deal?
I see you like cheese, correct?
I do like cheese.
Cool. What if I give you my cheese and you give me some of the other food that you don't want because I'm lactose intolerant and I can't eat cheese or else it upsets the stomach?
But I can't. You're lactose intolerant even in this world?
Yep, I'm bringing it over.
Muffins are ready.
Except IRL, I would eat all of the dairy and power through the pain. But here, I don't think I want to go through this. So,
like, I don't think I want to shit in a bush. So,
I'd rather not shit in the bush.
If Flick is willing to trade,
I'm gonna draw these shoes sitting in a bush.
Pair a pack. So.
Don't draw me shitting in a bush.
Oh my god, John, you should sit in a bush.
If you do that, that is one bit of art I'm not sharing with stream.
This is gonna be like half your body in a bush.
I had to pee in a bush once. It was not fun. Don't ever do that.
So much easier.
Oh, every road trip ever leads to like one person having to like piss in the grass or piss on the side of the road.
It's so much easier when they're AMAB.
It sucked because the bathroom was closed. The bathroom was closed. I had to go really bad and there was a bush. My parents were like, you're gonna have to pee in the bush. I'm like, I don't want to pee in the bush. They're like, you gotta do it.
This is why we always bring hand sanitizer anytime we go on road trips.
No, I didn't do that.
Yeah, we do it just
squat
in case.
And get up and you go on with your life.
Well, that's the thing. We use hand sanitizer just because, like, I don't want you touching anything in the car after you just pissed. So you're gonna clean your hands and then we're gonna go.
We asked her, "Do you want the cheese or not?"
I was saying, me and Flick share a pack. So.
Oh right. Like, would you like some cheese as well?
Yes.
Cool.
I'm back.
Welcome back.
Here is my ration of cheese in exchange for whatever food item you may have that does not contain dairy.
Yeah, you can have the meat.
Cool. Thank you. I'll put the meat in the pack.
Alright.
Nibble on a little bit. Nom.
So, yeah. So, Flick and Aster, you now have more cheese. Nishu, you now have more meat. Alright. You guys set off again. For day two of this 5-day journey.
Yippee!
Well, sorry, correction. It's five days to the next town. To your final destination, is another 1, 2, 3, 4,
oh,
5,
shit,
6,
I just
7,
fully
8.
Realized there's a town in front of Tentailed.
Yeah,
what?
It's another 5 days after that next town.
Oh, we're supposed to be going to the other town. Wait, which town are we going to?
You're
going into the one in between the Sky Daggers and Krom.
We're going north.
Kramor, yeah, okay.
Yeah.
I thought we were going. Okay.
don't worry. You gotta make. You're just heading on this north road. That's the important part. You're just traveling that. You guys carry on. I need to check my notes of your guys' stats. Hold on. I'll be able to tell you stuff in a
holding
second.
Holding on.
Good.
Holding, pausing, stopping.
Alright.
Let's see.
Moving on. 15. 16.
Pause button. Frozen in place.
Simon says stop.
11. 11, 13.
Red light? Green?
15. Okay. So Asta, Nishu, and Faerith. You three see this.
Yeah.
You other three do not.
Oh shit.
Wait, what's happening?
So you three see a beard. But it's not a normal
beard?
Beard.
A bird.
A bird.
Oh no.
But it's not a normal beard. It's
you just see a floating beard.
You're like cutting in and out for me, so it's a bird.
The
beard, it's flying away.
you see a bird. Definitely not a normal bird. Actually, it's funny that it's you three that see this. Because you three are probably the three that would be able to recognize why this isn't normal. Faerith, because of your years of hunting. No,
that's right.
Faerith, your years of hunting. Aster, you've traveled a bit. So you've probably been hunted by a few birds. And Nishu, because of your arcane knowledge. I say that arcane knowledge because this bird is shimmering with a sort of red sheen. Almost like
shiny.
Almost like it glows red. It kind of looks like a raven, but it's almost glowing red. As it just flies above you for a bit before speeding up and flying off towards a small village you see ahead of you at this sort of crossroads.
Do we... Guys, there's a village. Are we going?
Guys, there's a crazy-ass bird that just flew into this village. Let's go see what it is.
Yeah. So this village is on the crossroads. The map I gave you only has the capital cities and then the larger towns. It does not have every small village.
Ooh.
Got it.
Damn.
The small villages are, like I said, small, and maybe like a street long. So it takes you like 10 minutes to get through them, 20 at most. Whereas the villages I've shown, well, the towns I've shown you, they're like a day travel.
Damn.
So if you guys want to go to the town, perhaps we can pick up some crockery and such.
You really want a fucking pan, don't you?
So, you are the only one that wants a pan.
I mean, in case you guys want a pan in the future, we at least have one. I guess
you would have
pull Rapunzel and smack someone with that.
if you want to avoid the town, you're gonna have to go off the main road, which will slow your journey.
Okay, this bird can either be one of two things.
Not really.
Good or bad.
How about we go into the village and dodge the bird?
Okay.
I agree.
Are you guys still walking as you're having this conversation, or do you stop to...
We're walking.
We're walking.
Okay.
Walking and talking.
We're making our way downtown.
Alright.
Been a long day. So, to see this weird bird.
It's late afternoon as you guys arrive at this village. And, you know, there's some people just kind of going about their business. You see some kids playing about. There's a notice board kind of posted up next to one of the larger buildings. This village is sort of placed directly on this crossroads. So, you know, there's roads heading east, west, north, and south. And then a sign directly in the middle. If you translated it to modern day, this would be a lovely roundabout. But yeah, it's just got a nice sign with the directions pointed. You know, telling you what's in each direction. Jabaskas, is this town, this village, just got used to people passing by and stuck the sign up so that people stopped asking what was in what direction?
I walk up to the first person I see and ask them in what's in each direction.
Oh my.
They'll be like, at the sign!
No, not actually. I
No? Okay.
That would be fucking funny, though.
Alright, yeah. So, there's just people going about their business. You see kids playing games. You see, actually...
Where'd the bird go?
You don't see the bird.
Yeah, where'd the bird go?
You don't see the bird.
Bird left the chat.
It was never there! We all hallucinated.
Do I have knowledge on the bird? I want to know if it was good or bad.
Yeah, do I have knowledge on the bird?
Okay.
Do
what
I? Specifically,
what are you trying to discern about the bird?
What kind of bird it even was?
Nature check. Nishu? What are you trying to
I want to know if it was a good omen or a bad omen.
Arcane. Or Arcana check.
What kind of check am I doing?
You're doing a nature check.
We'll go with the coffee ones. Arcane.
Nature. I get a plus one.
You're doing nature, you're doing Arcana.
I got Arcana.
18 plus 3.
19. Alright. We'll start with Faerith. This was absolutely a raven. No doubt about it. That's a... Weirdly, it's almost like the perfect raven. Like, if you described a raven, this would be a perfect rendition of it. It had no flaws. Now, every bird has, like people, birds, there is no perfect version of one. You know, their tail might be a little bigger or a little smaller, their wingspan may be a little crooked. No, this one, perfect. You could not imagine more perfect raven. As for Nishu, you had 21, correct?
Yeah.
Alright. Your best guess, best bet about this bird, given its glowing aura and its speed as well, and the way it sort of just changed immediately, this was almost definitely someone's familiar. It was not a real bird. It was created and summoned, and it belongs to someone. Now, whether it's been sent to scout ahead, or was scouting the road behind them, or what, you don't know, but it was definitely a familiar.
Guys, the bird, I just remembered, was a familiar. It looked like one to me. Just letting you all know.
And then I just say, oh, that would explain why it was so perfect.
Mm-hmm.
It was one sexy bird.
First you lick a tree, now you call a bird sexy. I can't with you right now, man.
He's a ranger. What do you expect?
That's true.
We all slowly turn to Faerith, just like,
Oh yeah, most people, nobody in the party knows, we don't know each other's backgrounds too well, so nobody knows that I spent most of my time in the woods hunting. So yeah. My comment just seems like out of left field. They're like, what the fuck?
Out of context.
You want to have sex with the bird? What is wrong with you?
No. You misunderstand. But I don't elaborate further than that.
It makes sense, though, with the tree licking.
Yeah.
Kenku are a species.
No.
Looks like even more skeptical of Faerith now, just like backs away.
Let's just cover flick real quick as like a defensive line.
Me too.
Stay away from the small bird. We will attack.
I'm not even paying attention to this. I'm just looking around the other direction.
How dare you not pay attention to this conversation about you?
He was like, sexy bird. And they just started looking around the town. And we're just like...
Alright. Eventually, from you guys just standing in the center of town, of this village...
Jason!
Hello?
Wonderful. Alright. Yeah, that's probably half meal. So, from standing in the center of this town, a young lady walks up to you guys and is like, hello, can I help you with anything?
Yes, I'm looking for some place where I could find pots and pans and other crockery.
The general store might have some stuff. And she just kind of points to it.
Where might that be?
She just points to a building.
Okay.
She points to one of, like, the 10 buildings in this village.
Oh, there's that few? Okay.
It is not a big village.
See, I base, like, size based off of travel distance, and when you said 20 minutes, I'm like, oh, so this is still fairly large.
But then I mean, I'm exaggerating a bit when I say, like, 10. But no, that's...
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I say thank you, and then I also ask them, like, have you happened to see... Oh, somebody redeemed the hydrate. Two hydrates.
Fuck's sake. You guys trying to drown me? What are the shit?
Three hydrates! I should probably stop counting.
Why is there no cooldown on the hydrate?
There is no cooldown on the hydrate, because... Alright, I'm gonna have to go refill my pint. Because three hydrates is more than I do.
Quench your thirst.
I'll be back in a second.
I need to quench mine, speaking of.
Thank you.
Drink my water.
I actually have a beverage for one.
Ah. I forgot that button to mute me for screen. That's better. Wait, hold on. That didn't work.
Buddy.
Wait, Panda, are you gonna go get your water, or do I have a second to, like, ask a question of this all?
I'm gonna go get this water real quick. Everyone go take a quick, like, 2 minute break.
2 minute break.
You good?
That's what I read the message as. Wait, how many other people is this their first D&D experience?
I think literally it's me and Tyves, me and my sisters, and I believe it's Onyx as well.
Also mine.
Also yours. So most of the party.
Yeah, okay. Well, that's cool.
God. This is my second time experience. We never even finished the first campaign, and I really like my campaign.
That'll happen.
So how's everyone's day going?
Good. Woke up. Started playing D&D. Still playing D&D. But now I have muffins, so.
What kind of muffin?
Blueberry.
I'm sleeping.
Yeah, my dad's blueberry muffins are like the best.
Okay, noodle.
I'm not a big fan of blueberry muffins, to be honest.
Oh yeah, and gashin.
Blueberry.
Chocolate chip. For the win.
I don't like I don't know what it is. Something about chocolate chips, like, in the morning, like, throws off my stomach. It's just like, what is this fucking liquid deliciousness entering my body? I'm just like, too early. Blueberries, on the other hand, I'm just like, ah, yes, hot fruit.
Blueberry.
I woke up at, like, 5:30 again. I'm like, no, jeez. I'm not making the same mistake yesterday. So I went back to sleep.
Smart. Do you get up that early because you're so used to going to work?
Yeah. Sad days.
For a while, I just got up at 8 because I usually get up like an hour before I start streaming.
See, I have to get my streaming schedule more consistent because people watch my VODs, apparently. Like one of my, my most recent one had 8 views, and then the one before that had like 25, and I'm like, oh. People watch my shit. I just need to stream more consistently.
When did you stream?
I'm back.
I think you were. I streamed a lot the past week, as in twice.
I haven't seen you stream at all, unless you do it at like 11.
It was late. One of them was like, yeah, I think it was like at like 11, and the other one wasn't too late. I just don't think you saw.
Well, I go to bed at like 8:30, 9 o'clock. So.
Oh, then that, yeah, you did, Grandma was asleep.
Grandma Moth was asleep.
Grandma Moth was tucked in into the cocoon. Oh, you should do a little art where, like, you use, like, your original cocoon, but, like, you have it, like, as a hammock. Then the moth uses it, and then it has, like, a little moth blanket.
Aw.
That's cute.
Be cool.
I like cute shit. I don't know why. I mean, I don't know why you wouldn't like cute things.
Oh, I was very confused. I was like, where'd my phone go? And then I realized it's right there.
I was gonna say, you were just Snapchatting me like less than like 15 minutes ago. I was like, how did you lose your phone? I don't think you moved.
There's this website that I found. Where'd it go? This one, called Trinket Sorceress, and it has like accessories for like your headset.
Ooh.
And I was like I saw it on TikTok, and I saw like these like demon horns and the crown. I'm just like, I want that. But also they have moth things, and I was like, oh no, which one do I get?
I think I do know the one that you're talking about.
The moth ones or the. You the crown and the horns. I don't know.
Get both.
Get both.
I'll buy them tomorrow with my credit card. When I don't have to pay off my credit card. Because today's the last day. I'll do that. It's already kind of expensive, but it's fine. Accessories.
Okay, so while Nugget is gone, I decided to look through my January recap. So apparently, Wib is my chat's favorite emote. And the second one is the Ginger Love, which, you know, fair enough, that's a cute emote. But whereas Ginger Love was used 108 times, Wim was used 441 times.
Wow.
Amazing.
Everyone likes the worm.
I spent like 2 minutes drawing that. It was scuffed. It was meant to be shit. And everyone went, no, I love that shit. That's mine.
Everyone loves this the scuff one... stuff.
Yep.
Yep, worm. Holy shit.
A worm?
There were 2,927 chat messages sent. Fucking hell.
The total for all of it is so expensive. It's $92 for 3 things.
Then again, I expected this. My top emote is my spinning.
You spin me right around. Spin.
With 781 times.
Fuck hell.
Where? Yeah, wait.
It's expected. I even use it like excessively.
Wait, not where is that? Under which one?
It's in the recap.
You gotta go to your chat. Then go. Then it should have a pop up saying January recap.
PewDiePie and his wife are gonna have a bibby.
PewDiePie's married?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't. Married for years.
I don't watch his videos.
Neither do I, but it was like the biggest YouTuber news at the time.
Yeah.
I don't look at the news.
Wait, who's having a baby?
PewDiePie
and his wife.
Oh my god.
Well, congratulations to them.
Yeah.
I mean, they pretty recently lost their dog, I think, so...
Yeah.
Dog died, replaced with baby.
They're being reincarnated as a baby.
Oh.
I mean, that's how I think. I like to think that.
That's fair. God, I hope it doesn't take Nugget as long as it did last time to eat their food. Mm. We spent a long time stalling last week.
Yeah, we talked about anime for, like, I think, like, 25 minutes.
Oh, yeah, it was like a solid half hour of us just stalling.
Oh, speaking of which, I saw a really good cosplay today on Instagram, but it was also, like, depressing as hell. Oh, have you guys ever heard of the manga, hold on, I had it written down. I've read it once. Goodnight Pun Pun?
Oh my god, yes.
I haven't read it, but
I've watched, like, a fucking, like, 2 hour long video essay about it.
It is the most depressing, like,
it's so depressing, like,
it's like I've had manga where it's like it's sad because of how dark the story gets, and like if like I'm trying to think, Devilman Crybaby, that's like a generally manga. Like sad and lonely anime
I cry
and manga, but like this is just generally such a realistic depiction of like human like life and human tragedy that it just I was just like, oh my god, like
yeah.
And like this one cosplay girl I follow on Instagram, she like did a cosplay of like the main girl in that, and I was just like, oh no. she did it where like she did like the blacked out tooth too to make it look like it was me. I'm just like, Jesus Christ. Such a good manga. I would recommend, but like have like a great week before you start reading. Like you have to be like
you need to be in a good headspace for like, that.
I was gonna say you have to be at, like the peak of like your mental. It's like watching
Violet Evergarden.
Yeah. Like just anything that like will bring you down. Just you have to be at the peak of like your general like I feel great. Time to watch Schindler's List or something horrifyingly depressing, like
Jesus Christ.
This is I need a good cry now.
Mm-hmm. I cried every episode of Violet Evergarden only.
I've been too happy. Let's cry now.
I made
the
mistake of I was pulling an all-nighter and I was like working on finals and I was like, oh, let me, you know, put on something in the background, and I would have to periodically stop to wipe the tears out of my face so that I could continue working on my finals.
It's so good. And it's so pretty, too. Ugh, the animation.
And I didn't learn, because then I do that, and then I watch freaking Belle, which makes me cry every single time.
Mm-hmm.
So I would just, like, I'd be watching, like, this is great, this is fine, and then I'd be like, hold on, let me wipe the tears out of my face, and we can continue.
That was the thing. I genuinely did not expect to cry when we watched Belle.
is so good. It is. Like, you're really like, good. Oh, it'll be sad. That's fine. And then you go, oh no.
That is so much worse than I thought.
Like, I watched it with my brother, and I'm not going to spoil anything in case anyone hasn't seen it. But at the end, when she, at the end when she meets the boys, and like all of that went down, my brother, like, who had been like watching somewhat, but like we're both ADHD, so we're kind of like on our phones watching, and he fucking just full on gasped, and I was like, mm-hmm. And I'm like just watching him, and I'm like, mm-hmm. He like looks at me, and I'm like, yeah. And he's like, the fuck. It, oh, so good.
Yeah, I haven't seen Violet Evergarden.
This was the movie Belle, but yes.
Oh, Belle.
Another recommendation. Another high recommendation. Mm. Watch both.
Oh, I'm sorry. I've seen the trailer for this like a billion times. It's the one where, like, she, like, somehow loses her voice in real life, but then, like, in this digital thing, she can still sing, right?
Well, it's not that she loses her voice. Anytime she tries to sing in real life, she gets violently ill.
Oof.
Because of trauma. It's great. I love that movie. I might watch it when we're done. Who doesn't love a good cry?
I cried during the sinking scene during the Titanic.
See, I mean, I probably cried.
I couldn't take the Titanic too seriously.
Yeah.
Admittedly, I was watching it in history class, but also I had seen someone talking about a thing previously, about how they had a teacher who got kicked out of the theater because as the ship was sinking and like people were falling into the water, he was shouting diving scores.
What were they doing?
They were shouting diving scores.
Oh. Could you imagine?
Completely undercuts the entire scene. It makes it hilarious, but my god.
The one that got me was what made me cry was like the scenes where they showed like different passengers' reactions to what was happening. And there was like the old couple who was just laying in the bed and holding each other, and then the parents like saying goodnight to their like reading them a bedtime story to the kids while like they could see the water filling up the floor. And I was like, oh my god, like that got me. And then like, oh, the captain when he just shuts the door to like the thing, I'm like, no, you can leave. No, I was just like, damn, fucking tragic.
Yeah, I will say my favorite and historically accurate story of the Titanic has to be the ship's cook, who realized the ship was sinking and went, you know what, screw it, I'm gonna die. If I'm gonna die, I'm gonna do it really drunk. And so just got really drunk and was like, you know what, I'm gonna help people out. So started helping people get off the ship and was like, I'm gonna go get more drunk. And then went and got more drunk and then helped more people. And then went and got more drunk. And then when the ship sank, he just swam.
He's like, yeah, this is fine.
Yeah, he just swam his way and lived. Because he was so drunk, and his body was basically just keeping itself warm. Because it was just like, no, I'm not cold. And semi-placebo effect, one, because of the alcohol in his system, it was just physically heating him up, and he just lived because of it. He lived because he got so drunk he couldn't freeze to death.
Amazing.
Honestly, kind of impressive.
Oh, it was amazing. He saved a ton of people as well.
I really like the musicians that played as the ship sank.
Oh, that was depressing. I don't think any of them actually survived in real life either, like the actual sinking of the ship.
No, not
like me. Can you imagine though, like knowing you're going to die, knowing so many people are going to die, and you're like, let's give us some background music.
I mean,
I think it was to keep people calm so they wouldn't feel like
depressed. I think it was much like the parents reading their kids a story. It's just the thing of just like, look, there's not much we can do at this point.
Mm-hmm.
Let's just accept our fate and do what we do. Now, the Titanic is an interesting thing. I will say, it does lead to one of my favorite lines in Doctor Who. Where there's some army general saying about how the space is, like, impregnable or something. And the Doctor is just like, yeah, I don't like the word impregnable. And the general's like, why? He's like, sounds a bit too much like unsinkable. And it just perfectly fits the Doctor's mentality of just like, yeah, no, look, history repeats itself. Don't be stupid.
I was gonna say, didn't the ship literally get destroyed in that episode?
Mm-hmm. That's old Who.
Oh, are you talking about the one with the space Titanic?
No, yeah. That's what I'm thinking of. That's a completely different episode. The one I was referring to is old Who. The Space Titanic is New Who. That was the David.
I remember. I
watched somewhat with my brother, starting with like the ninth Doctor. So I don't actually know all that much.
Okay, that's fine. I'll make you watch.
I've seen every season and episode of the new Doctor Who, starting from the reboot with
Christopher
Eccleston. Peter
Capaldi.
Also, I teared up a little bit once while watching the Titanic, like the Space Titanic episode, but I think it was just because back then I used to smoke a lot of weed, and I was just like, yeah, this is emotionally doing something for me here, but I couldn't put my finger on it.
In fact, it is an emotional episode.
Yeah. Well, what got me is, like, I think, I don't want to give spoilers, but also this episode is, like, a billion years old. But, and it's also not, like, a main plot line thing. Well, somebody dies who the Doctor was like, oh, yeah, like, really, like, getting close to. They die, and then, like, he, like, takes, like, two of, like, the robot angels, and they fly him up. And for some reason, that whole thing happening at once, like, I don't know, it just, like, emotionally did something to me, and I just started tearing up, and I'm just like, man.
No, that's fair.
The episode that always gets me is when the Doctor brought Van Gogh to the museum.
Mm.
Oh, yeah.
I saw that clip on Instagram the other day. And I was just sitting there, I'm like, don't cry, don't cry, don't cry, don't cry, don't cry. I'm like feeling my eyes well up, and I'm like, ugh, that entire like episode.
What's funny to me is I find that one of the less emotional episodes.
Granted, art student. So like,
well, that's fair.
It touches but... it twinges my heart a little more.
That's fair. But no, I think
Vincent Van Gogh has always been poggers.
Yes. I think personally for me, the episodes of Doctor Who that hit me more are the ones that had like a ton of build up for them. And you know, the ones that really do sort of hammer home mostly towards, like, the ending episodes, like, the ending arc of one of the, companions, or something like that.
Oh, the best build-up to payoff to, like, sad ratio for me, I feel like, was the entire, like, I forget what season it was the end of, but it was like the whole Dr. Donna plot line.
Yeah, no, that was
that one got me, because that was really a really fucking sad ending.
Especially when you go back and they meet for the first time and she's like, do you not know who I am? And it's just like, you're like, cool, I guess I didn't need a heart anyway. Thanks.
Wait, hold on. Real quick, which Dr. Donna part are you talking about?
Literally right before he regenerates. That
okay,
part.
So, like, so the whole... end of David Tennant's thing.
Yeah, yeah. When the master comes back and does all his master stuff and
yeah, no. So
also, oh, Zero is here, but also their Twitch is dying apparently.
No, I think it's just the stream delay.
Oh. Yeah, no, I ironically love Doctor Who, but, like, I don't like talking to other people for the most part who like Doctor Who because, like, I don't know. Sometimes I feel like some people take it way too fucking far.
Yeah, some Doctor Who fans can be a bit annoying.
I mean, that's the same with any fandom. It was literally because of, like, anime kids in high school prevented me from watching anime for, like, another, like, 2 years before somebody was like, hey, you want to watch Kill la Kill with me? And I'm like, oh, okay, sure. And yeah. Then I'm just like, ha, this is a weird but fun experience. I think I'll watch more.
Yeah.
Literally, that's what happened with me and Hamilton. I refused to watch it because of someone I didn't like liked it. And then now I'm just like, Alexander Hamilton. Hell yeah.
I prefer In the Heights. I really like In the Heights.
Oh, I like it as well.
I don't like the
Oh, again, In the Heights. Again, another like movie that made me cry, and I was just like, "Oh God."
I haven't watched.
I'm an emotional made person. Cry. Apparently,
that was a sad movie.
Smile too much. Like I chuckle and like I start crying. So I can.
You're like,
literally, my eyes water like nobody else's. It is annoying.
Nice.
Wait, Lindsay, you said you cried while watching In the Heights?
Yeah. Mm. It's like when the scene in Moana when the grandma dies and like comes back. That's sad, man.
Yeah. I know exactly what you're talking about. Yeah, and it didn't help that the grandma reminded me of my grandma, and I was just like, no!
Mm-hmm.
That there's like two animes that made me sad. It was when I was back in high school and I was watching it. Anohana and Angel Beats. Those things made me sad, man.
My heart.
I've heard that Angel Beats is a really destroyed. Sad one.
It's really You're good and evil.
I heard that both of them are pretty emotional, so
yeah. They are, yeah. But they're really good though.
Oh yeah. You're Lying April.
I actually haven't watched the whole thing of that yet. I need to watch it.
You totally should. You will be emotionally destroyed. But I feel like it's one of those things that like any anime watcher needs to go through.
Hmm.
It's a staple anime.
I really struggle watching shows. As Sea Salt can attest to.
We know. I love you, Pan. We need to finish fucking Arcane.
I know.
I heard Arcane was unironically good. Like, for something based off of League of Legends, it's like ridiculously good.
Here is the thing I've learned.
I'm going to go on a small rant. Arcane is one of the most beautiful shows I have ever seen in my entire life. It is perfection. The story itself is amazing. They take the great elements that League of Legends has with its storytelling. They take these characters and they build out a world that is so realistic. It's so believable. And like, yes, you have very normal humans. But you also have, like, these fantastical creatures, and none of it is out of place, and it works. And you have magic, and you have technology, and all of it is just, it is amazing. And then you have the art style. It is, like, that semi-realistic, but it still has those cartoon elements. It's so beautiful. Like, everything is just amazing.
And I've been the
music! I have returned. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I heard the music was good. I've been so excited with the way the animation in general has been going. Like, for everything, especially in anime. Like, I don't know if anybody's watched Chainsaw Man yet. I'm
Yes.
The combination between, like, the 3D, like, they, like, I can see that they're using, like, rotoscoped 3D to, like, insert into, like, two-dimensional, and I'm like, oh my god, this looks so good. Yeah, like, although there's some parts where you can tell that it's a little bit funky still, like, if you go to the part where...
We'll always have that.
Yeah, because, like, if you watch the episode where Denji is in, what's-her-face's apartment, there's a scene where you can see she walks from, like, the hallway to look into the door, and it looks really fucking weird, like, fucked up and weird in that one scene, like... The only reason I notice it is because, like, I'm used to, like, looking at videos and stuff for editing.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, what the hell is... And I played it back, and I'm like, oh my god, this is this style of... And I thought it was really cool, but I'm like, that's the only time where I thought it looked weird in that show.
Yeah, they probably just relied too heavily on it if they're using it for such a small shot like that. Like, it's fine in some instances. Like, even in one of my classes, we're looking, there's... In 101 Dalmatians, there's that scene where he's coming up with the tune and she's like calling him down for dinner and he's like playing the piano.
I realize I'm like, back at, right?
Yes. Yeah. He like goes down the stairs and you can tell that they had someone actually do that because he has such like humanistic, like realistic quirks. Whether it's like the head swivel or like the hands, like it's, but they were able, they didn't like fully rotoscope it. Like it was very heavily referenced, but it was done in a very nice way.
Well, that's what they used to do too, with like certain animations. If they're like, I can't fucking draw this by hand, they take a video clip and they just draw the scene over each individual frame. Or they did that a lot in, I was going to say, it was done for, Sleeping Beauty and Snow White were two of the ones I can remember the most that they did.
Yeah, because that was also early Disney, you know, the 20s, 30s, when it was still new, especially with Snow White.
Lucy, what the fuck?
Well, Snow White was quite literally the 20s. Pretty sure. And so it was still, all of that technology was very new, and so you're getting into this brand new thing called animation, and you're like, oh, it's a moving drawing. How the hell do you draw someone dancing? Like, it's very difficult, as is. But with it being brand new, it's like, it's understandable, and it works well, and they did it well. But...
Nugget, what you got there?
Tiramisu.
Ooh, tiramisu.
Okay, I'm gonna interrupt your conversation.
The package literally says, "Watch it contains alcohol." Whoops.
Well, it contains alcohol. All right, I'm gonna interrupt the conversations here, and force us back into D&D.
Oh boy,
that is valid. I was gonna end my rant anyway, or else I would have continued on too long because
We can talk about like history. Animation and art and shit for like hours.
I'm literally
going to school for animation, so same.
Well, maybe after the session, I will add a quick thing about Arcane that I thoroughly enjoy it. My brain just won't let me watch it. And as for the whole sort of it's really good for a thing based on League of Legends. What I've learnt is. League of Legends stuff, everything but the game, everything else, the music that they make, the shows that they make, the, like, comics they make, all absolutely phenomenal. The game, eh.
Well, here's the thing. I've heard that the game itself isn't bad. Like, it's a decent game. It's the community of players that make it so bad.
Yeah, the community is dog shit. I used to play that game. My roommate was Korean, so obviously they all, so he played League, and so did his two friends who were also from Korea. So they were always in my room, and they're like, oh, John, you should play. And I tried playing. Literally the first game I played, I got a temporary ban on my account for like kill feeding. And I'm just like, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm trying to learn. How are you going to all like people in that game are like cruel to new players. They're like, oh, you don't know what you're doing? Get banned for like a week. And I'm like, what the fuck?
Yeah. Yeah. Luckily we're playing a much better game.
If you want to know how much I hyperfixated on the music of the show, my Spotify rap top artist, my number one artist last year, was League of Legends. I listened to that soundtrack on repeat for like weeks on end.
I still haven't finished watching it.
Where? All of you!
And yeah. This all's getting agitated because my brain won't let me watch it, despite the fact that I want to. Anyway, D&D.
I'm gonna go cry.
Oh yeah, back to
D&D. The reason we're here.
I asked the old lady. I think I asked where the shop was.
She is a young lady. We're not doing this again. Young lady, not old lady.
Oh, it's a young lady.
Yes, young lady. We've done this before.
What?
I'm an old.
Oh yeah, with the librarian, where...
But suddenly she just aged.
The young lady. Okay, I asked the lady where the thing was. Oh, and then I was gonna ask one other question, but then Nugget went to go get their food.
Yes.
Can I ask my other question now?
Yeah.
Tomato soup.
Oh yeah, so I'll ask, excuse me, did you see a shiny bird happen to land around here, or know who it belongs to?
A shiny bird? What do you mean by that?
I forget, you told me what kind of bird it was, because I recognized it.
It was a raven.
Shiny bird.
It was a perfect raven.
Yeah, did you happen to see a raven that looked unnaturally good, like, proportion wise as well as with a shiny glowing red hue to it?
I don't believe I have.
Okay, well thank you for the information.
I'm confused. You mean to say you've seen a glowing red raven?
Yes, and other people in my party did as well.
It had like a glowing aura about it, but for the most part it was just a raven. Have you seen like a raven flying?
Possibly a familiar.
Oh, like a mage's pet. No, I don't believe I have.
Okay.
No, this is peculiar. I've not seen anything nor heard of anything like that.
Alright, thanks.
Thank you.
We tried.
Yeah, she walks away. And you see as she kind of heads over to a building. You see as she kind of walks over to a building, like knocks on the door, and then someone dressed quite well. You know, they got fancy clothing and stuff.
What?
Oh, Zero is so far behind. They've got some quite fancy clothing. Your best guess is they are maybe the mayor of this town or something. Yeah, she's just talking to them. You do notice that she kind of points to you guys.
Oh!
Guys, I think someone's pointing at us.
I wave.
I'll be like, what?
The mayor looks at you guys, and, you know, sees Faerith, waving. Just kind of brings the lady inside.
Oh, they're skeptical of us. They think we're crazy.
We just came here. Of course they think we're weird.
You guys showed up and went, have you seen a strange bird? Oh, what's this? Ah!
It's Atlas.
Atlas.
He probably won't see it until, because the delay is so bad.
He won't see it in 20 minutes.
30?
Well, what do we do now? I guess we're getting out of here, because this isn't where we're supposed to be.
yeah, this is just a town. Yeah, I guess we gotta way. But, you know, there's still that whole glowing bird thing. Was that a...
Sidetracked with that glowing thing. Probably go to another dimension again.
I mean, dimension hopping is, well, realm hopping isn't that common. In fact, it's quite rare. Mm-hmm. You're one of the few people alive. Well, you guys are one of the few groups of people alive to have dimension hopped. No, realm hopped, rather.
All right, you guys want to look into this bird thing or no? Because I'm saying I don't know. I'm saying no.
Don't mind. I mean, we could look into it, but also, you know.
Okay, I need a yes or no answer.
We should just keep going.
Last thing, if it's a bad thing, then you know, it'd probably be a good thing to deal with it. If it's not a bad thing, then, you know, don't fix what's not broken.
I mean, if it's just somebody's pet, then I don't see why we have to look into it. What do you guys
think? True. I agree with our leader.
Nishu, you would know that it doesn't necessarily, a familiar isn't technically a pet. It's more just like a servant thing. It is a summoned creature, and it can do a lot of things. You know, people can see through the eyes of it. It can some of them might even be able to cast certain simple spells.
Sorry, I was... Okay. Sorry, I've been spacing out. Well, what's happening? this works for my character.
Talking about the familiar.
Yeah, oh, okay.
So they mentioned about how the familiar is someone's pet.
Yeah, how familiar works.
You would know that a familiar isn't quite just someone's pet. It is almost an extension of them. And so if that person has any malicious intent, the familiar could exact that. You know, the person can see through its eyes. Sometimes the familiar can cast basic spells. Or it could be used to steal things. What the familiar is used for and what it can do is a bit extensive and varies on the person. So, you know, it could be a very bad thing for this village. It could also just not matter.
The question is, do we want to look into this or not? Because I'm saying no, and Rosé's saying no.
I'll go with majority vote on this one.
I kind of want to take a look-see.
Okay. Flick. Lucia.
What, where?
I will be right back while you guys decide. I'm gonna go turn on my light.
Okay.
What are we deciding on?
Whether or not to the familiar or not. The bird.
I mean, it could be interesting. Maybe there's a very cool person there whose familiar it is, and they can tell us information about our journey.
Okay, so two votes.
Hey, yes. What do you think?
Flick.
Yeah, Flick, you're kind of like the deciding factor on this.
Flick can't speak. Well, they can, but...
Right.
I'll be honest, I have been blanking out. What is happening?
Okay.
We're deciding whether or not to look into the familiar.
Yeah.
Oh. Was anyone gonna pick?
And so far, it's 2-4. And if you pick, it'll break and then because Nishu is siding with whoever has majority vote.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord. Ooh, more zero memes. I love that zero. Thank you.
Bird or no bird? That is the question.
It's Onyx meme this time. We post it.
Alright.
Oh, I don't know. Because part of me is wondering if it possibly, what's his face? Calyx? If it's possibly Calyx's,
why don't we ask B?
We could ask Bean.
You could ask Bean. You all kind of forgot
Bean,
what was you there.
Do we look into the familiar or not?
We might hold off and just keep an eye out, and if we see that it's still following us, then we check it out.
So overall, that's a no.
Yeah.
Basically, keep going.
Bean, what do you think?
No until later, if it persists.
None of you have.
Yeah, so my question about Bean, they're with us, but they're not sentient right now. They're a little...
They're fully sentient.
They just can't speak.
I didn't know. Okay, I didn't know that Bean was, like, sentient. I thought they had just straight up turned into, like...
They are a sentient flame that just can't speak. However, you guys all can recognize the light they give off is not normal light.
I go to Lucia and look in the lantern. Hey, Bean.
The two eyes kind of look up to you.
I love Pete.
What do you think we should do?
I'd just be aggressively staring at the fire. I'm like, need answers right now.
It just kind of flickers around a bit, almost like it's doing a little dance. It's trying its best to communicate. Before it hops out of the lantern.
Oh, God.
and onto the
floor.
It sort of lands on the floor and very quickly writes out Strange Bird and jumps back into the lantern. And as it jumps kind of back in, you see that it's almost as though it was in pain doing that.
I just fall away with my eyes and I'm like, what the f*** is happening?
But yeah, now slightly on fire in the ground is just the words Strange Bird.
Oh. Bean doesn't even like the bird. We're leaving.
Well, that was a clear answer.
Yep. What was it?
So. Very clear. Let's go.
All right. If you say so. Let me just.
Wait, what do you mean if you say so? That's ominous. Nope. You know what? I'm not going to think about it. Let's go.
Yeah, hold on. Let me just. I'm making notes. Alright. So. Yes. You guys are just leaving this town? Because, like I said, it's
we were going to buy a horse!
It's early evening, late afternoon.
I needed to buy pans still.
You need to buy a pan and...
Medium saucepans, say.
Medium saucepans!
Why is that?
I go to the pans. I walk over to the pan store.
It's
the or general. Whatever store that they pointed to that had pans.
It's the general
store.
General crockery and such.
Convenience store. Yeah.
It's just got things that people like trade in or sell that, you know, your average town people may need to buy.
Hmm.
Yeah, so you can head in there. It's small. You could probably, if you really tried, touch
this is
both
the dramatic
walls.
Dramatic music for buying a pot. Anyways, I want to buy a horse.
Where are you gonna buy a horse in a village this small?
There's no horse in the general store.
Just on the wall. There's a horse.
There's a horse on the wall.
Look at him. It's staring through the window. He's staring through
just
the window.
Just staring at us.
Is this the wanted horse?
You guys still haven't found the wanted horse. I made that a full character out of a joke. But yeah, you see some basic things. There's a bit of food. There's like two books on a shelf, and yes, some various kitchen things. Oh, more hydrate.
Hydrated, I straight.
Is there a person at the? Is there like a person behind the counter?
Yeah, there's someone that. Are they asleep? You can't tell. They're either asleep or they just kind of got their eyes shut and are really bored. But they're just kind of.
I say hello.
Hi. How can I help you?
Okay, good. Yes, I need a. I would like a cast iron frying pan, please, and a small pot to boil some water in.
He kind of looks over to where the various sort of kitchen equipment is. Yeah, there's a pot and a pan there.
How much are these?
There's a sign on them. I don't remember it off by heart.
Damn, these people have crippling depression.
I guess I read what the pans and pots say on it for price.
No, stretch. Okay. The pan is, 3 silver, the pot is 4.
3 and 4, and I have 8. Okay, perfect. I buy both.
Okay.
For 7 silver.
Yeah, as you grab both, the guy just kind of puts out a hand. For the money.
I drop the money in their hand.
I just kind of put it in this little bag behind the counter. Like, anything else you want to buy?
What else is in there?
Honestly, very small village stuff. You've got,
Can we buy horses here?
I inspect the books on the wall, or whatever they, or wherever they were. The two books.
There's two books on a shelf, along with some small wooden toys and things. One of the books is a book of fairy tales. The other is a book called Traveler's Guide to Gerland.
It just says Traveler's Guide?
It's the Traveler's Guide to Gerland. That's the title of the book.
I buy both. Or I ask to buy both.
Yeah, no problem. He kind of just... He finally actually opens his eyes and looks and sort of squints. Just give me... I don't know. 2 silver.
This is how I would act in real life, too, since I have 90 gold and 1 silver. I ask, would you take 1 silver?
Roll me a persuasion.
Just give him a gold.
I have just a negative 1 persuasion. Oh, God. Huh?
Just give him a gold piece.
No. I'm rolling for this. Let's see. Oof. I got a 6.
Oh, Lord. I would have lent you some money, man.
He kind of looks... For the first time in this entire interaction, he looks